James Gowie. Of course, the Cato was written by Romanian composer Dinicu, and horror means either a dance or horror, as it's really scary to play. And staccato means it's just very short, so you have horror and staccato. Yeah, I've got a master's degree in music. Can you pull some
back? I can never.
Thank you.
waves of hate towards me. This is our meditation by Maslin. Incidentally, I'm doing this in the original key, but there is a harmonic that I have been trying to get. Well, unfortunately, the neighbor's dog was really unhappy about it, so I'm going to put that down the octave tonight, but the rest I'll keep as is.
Shame.
For health and safety.
Yeah, understood. Yeah.
Thank you.
When I was at the RNCM in Manchester, I had a teacher called Alan Hacker, who's a clarinetist. I'm not sure what he was doing with the soft name of saxophone, but he gave it to me as a gift, and he sadly died a year later, and his wife, slightly tongue-in-cheek, said, "I want you to play this instrument in his memory." And it's a wonderful, crazy little machine. We're going to play a baroque piece, which I've played before, but I'm still trying to get all the notes in, so I'm going to have another crack at it. And this is Adagio in Allegro by the Italian composer Leonardo Vinci.
Not to be confused with the Italian artist.
No, because they have no da.
No da.
Called Seamus, McGuire, traditional musician. He played this next piece called The Wishing Tree. And I liked it so much, he sent me his CD. It's a folk thing, but I've arranged it for sax and piano. My handwriting, I write with an Irish accent. So Will did this lovely thing with Sibelius. Look how pretty it is now. Thanks for that, Will. Beautiful work. It's based on a poem by Seamus Heaney. Seamus Heaney went to the same school as me, and in 2013, I was asked to work with him. And actually, my first ever composition was based on one of his poems called Midterm Break. And we were due to perform the piece together. Unfortunately, 3 weeks before the concert, he died. So it feels very weird and a bit appropriate, because I've just realized that this piece, The Wishing Tree, it's from a book called The Haw Lantern, and it's based on a poem that he dedicated to his mother-in-law, who he was very close to. And after she died, he wrote this piece, and there's a place in Ireland called Arbogue. And it's a very Irish story. People, especially when they were leaving to go out to war or emigrate, they would get a pin or a needle and stick it into this tree, hoping to come back to retrieve this from the tree. Of course, a lot of them never did come back, and the poor tree, it died of some metal lead poisoning. So the tree's kind of still there, so he kind of used it as a kind of inspiration. So I'll read the poem, and then we'll play my little arrangement of The Wishing Tree by Seamus McGuire. The Wishing Tree. I thought of her as the wishing tree that died, and saw it lifted root and branch to heaven, trailing a shower of all that had been driven, need by need by need, into its hale sapwood and bark. Coin and pin and nail came streaming from it, like a comet tail, new minted and dissolved. I had a vision of an airy branch head rising through damp cloud of turned up faces where the tree had stood. and thanks to you all for coming. We just love being here, it's also our gift to you all for all we get from being here. Thanks, of course, to Dawn for doing an amazing job, not just with sorting out this, but just for sorting out our timetables and everything. Really appreciate that. And of course to Arlette and Alan for just making this amazing, amazing place happen. So thanks to you all for coming. So we'll see you afterwards for a drink. This is, remember the guy I said, you know, had a few problems with his wife got stabbed and things. Well, this is a piece by him to finish off, and it's called Sax-o-phun. And it's a study in laugh and slap tongue. Slap tongue is a kind of very heavy way of slap tongue where you go like that. And the laugh is where you have to go like that. It's just based on that. So it could have been written for me. So there we go. Exactly. Rudy Wiedoeft, thanks for coming. Take it away, Will.
Thank you.
Together.